Hello everybody and welcome to 7 Days to Die. Today, I have Alpha 12.5. What is in 12.5 that's not in 12.4? I haven't a bloody clue. The release notes weren't in the Steam page when I was there looking, so I figured, what the hell. And I had this idea for a series. Let's see if I keep this one up. There is no end game for 7 Days to Die. There isn't. But there is, some really high-level stuff that you can do. And I was playing before on my own little server, and my goal was to make a minibike. It's one of the things that you could make. I think it's really neat that they added vehicles to the game. And I really, really, really wanted to see it. Now, this is really hard to make the mini bike. You have to get all kinds of parts together. You have to get blueprints and everything like that. So I qualify it as endgame level stuff. To get it, you have to basically beat the game. And I figured it would be an interesting series to create. That I would try to, get the mini bike, and once I got the mini bike, I had succeeded at the game. Well, I figured with the 12.5 update, this would be a great time to restart my world, which I did. I didn't have to because of like a save game reset or anything like that. The 12.5 update seems to work fine with my old save games, but I figured it was still a good time to do it. As you can see, I just actually it's 8 o'clock already. Holy crap. I did just start the server, and I don't think it should be this late unless time flows a lot faster. Doesn't look like it so far, but, what was I saying? Oh yes. I was going to point out that you may notice the date reset. So right now it says day one, and obviously I'm going to keep going as long as I can. I fear the day 7. I fear the 0.5 update because every single freaking update makes it harder. And I have no idea what they added to the 0.5 update. Ugh, scares the crap out of me. But you may notice that the day will reset every now and then. And the reason that it does that, assuming that the glitch is also in the 0.5 update, is because every time you restart a server, it resets the day. And I run my server on my, home PC, and while I try to leave it running as long as possible, my home PC is currently running Windows 10, and Windows 10 has the automatic update thing going for it, so it automatically restarts whenever the hell it feels like it. I have not actually noticed that yet, so yeah, I guess I'll see, but... I don't know. Now, you may wonder why I keep incessantly chopping down the cacti. The yucca fruit here are actually really good food. Ooh, and my axe is damn near running out of durability. There we go. Oh, better now. The yucca fruit is actually really good food, and it doesn't draw people or zombies. So, that's pretty cool. Let's see, what else do I need? I know I need a lot of wood. I have a few tricks up my sleeve. I don't know if they'll still work. But I have a few tricks up my sleeve to deal with these zombies. And of course, I spawn in the middle of another fucking desert. I've also noticed it looks a hell of a lot prettier. I have no idea what speed I'm running it, like the frame rate or anything is. I noticed some jitteries as I move around, look around. But I'm using Shadow Play to record NVIDIA's thing, NVIDIA screen recording software. And it works. Let me start from the beginning. I have tried to use Shadow Play since the beginning. Since it first came out, since it was in beta. It's still in beta. I heard a zombie, I think. I heard something. Oh, there's a zombie way the hell over there. I'm not going to deal with it because I don't have any decent weaponry yet. Let's see, what's a good weapon? A good weapon would be a bow. Yeah, don't want to be dealing with the zombies just yet. No, totally, totally not ready for dealing with the zombies. But yeah, a bow would be a good thing to start with. And some arrows, so I'm going to need some feathers. I'm going to need some more sticks. Lots more sticks, actually. I'm going to need a little time so I can make the bow. Come on. Come on! Sometimes the hitbox on these things is a little bit of a pain in the ass. I'm seriously noticing that everything looks crisper than it did previously in the previous update. Did they up the texture quality or something? I don't know. I'm not seeing anything that instantly strikes me as different. Just everything strikes me as different. And I am going off on so many tangents right now. Whee! Run the hell away, run the hell away. Yeah, no, I'm gathering up everything I can. Whee! Without dealing with the zombies. I'm gonna have to start doing that here very soon. Because if I don't, it's going to end up being a severe problem. Ooh, there is a road. Let's follow the road. Roads tend to end in a good place. One bottle of water. This is not terribly good. Anyways, I was talking about shadow play. Let's see, which way do I want to go? Let's go left. I don't know why, but let's go left. But I was talking about shadow play. Ever since shadow play became a thing, like it was in very early beta, first started, you know, all that, I started playing with it, trying to play with it anyways, and I have never once gotten it to work. Now, I've tried it under Windows 7, and it didn't work. It just didn't work for me. I know it can work under Windows 7, so I know it's a limitation on my part, but I could never figure out why. I mean, I was using, at the time, a 770? NVIDIA GTX 770? And, yeah, it refused to work. Latest drivers, beta drivers even, tried them, didn't work. Everything, you know, everything was a checkbox. You know, minimum processor speed. Well, minimum processor speed actually wasn't a checkbox. But my processor was way more powerful. They required like a Core i3 or something, or equivalent or something like that. And I had a Core i7. So I had way more power than needed. And I had read on forums and such that that was a common problem. That, you know, the processor just didn't check properly. You would see it wouldn't detect the processor properly. It wouldn't detect a higher level processor if you had one. So it wasn't a problem. It shouldn't have been a problem anyways. I had video cards. Ooh, I'm getting screen tearing. I'm not supposed to do that. Unless G-Sync doesn't work with this game, which is very possible. I don't know. Anyways, lost my train of thought here. I'm getting a shit ton of screen tearing now. Yeah, G-Sync is weird. Especially my monitor of G-Sync is very, very weird. It's not actually like G-Sync. Oh, I should grab that. I don't know if I need to grab the glass. Probably not yet, anyways, but... I'm looking for anything really interesting. I haven't seen anything yet. I'm actually following the road, mostly, because I'm looking for a... I don't know what I would call it. It's not a village when it's just, like, two shops. I got really, really lucky in the last world. We found, on, like, the second day, a... Born and Noble, I think that's what it was called, which is a bookstore. And what was that shop? Oh, and a Popping Pills. That's what it's called. And that was a pharmacy. So we had a lot of medicine right off the bat, and we had a lot of books right off the bat. And it was really, really cool. Really, really useful. And I got really lucky, apparently, that I got a Forge Ahead book, because apparently the Forge Ahead books are broken, or at least the spawn rate was broken. I'm hearing everything. The sound is still weird in this game. You can hear things from a lot farther away than you probably really should. Lose my train of thought. I'm bouncing around. I bounce around a lot. Ooh, there's an actual village. Well, most of one. I'm waiting for the rest to spawn in. Is it a big village? It's a full-sized village. All right, well, I'll keep track of where this is. I don't want to be fiddling around here yet. I should probably find a safe place and actually make a bow. Up there. Yeah, up there, because I'll be able to see everything around me. I have to find a really good place to chill for a while and do some prep work. I need some place to hide for the night, basically. That's my primary focus right now, is to find a place to hide for the night. Goldenrod and corn. Actually, I don't know how useful corn is. In the last game that I played, I was level 38 before I stopped playing, before I reset the world just today. And I never used corn once. Not really, anyways. Okay, so we got a road up here. I love how the roads are windy now. And that's a fucking bear. Oh, shit. Not only is that a fucking bear, it's a fucking bear chasing me. Shit, I'm not hungry. Okay, it's no longer chasing me. Whew, that scared the hell out of me. That is a hell of a cliff right there. That's a zombie. I'm gonna have to fight around here, aren't I? I think that might be a really good place to chill on the cliff for right now. Anyways, once I get away from the zombies. Yeah, I'm gonna have to fight my way through these people. I'm gonna die a lot in this game. Guaranteed. Just absolutely and completely guaranteed. Hell of a thing right there. Alright, so let's make a bow. No, not jabot. Just bow. Wooden bow. What do I need? Oh, I need grass. Well, there's plenty of grass around. I'm probably gonna draw a zombie doing this. Not yet. Ooh, I should gather up cotton too, but there isn't much cotton around here. I'm pretty much in the middle of a... Well, I'm on the edge of a desert now. Is that enough? Yes, that's enough. Craft you. That's gonna take several minutes. Got a zombie coming. I got several zombies coming. Still undetected, though. Let's head off in this direction. There's a zombie there. That guy found me. Hi, piggy. Wait, what the hell? Don't they run away from the player anymore? I guess it kind of makes sense. I mean, I have no idea how long after the apocalypse this game takes place, but it's very possible that the animals would lose their direct fear of humans, but they might be afraid of just new things in general, so I don't know. It's actually confusing how you should do this. I mean, how do you think that would work? Would they... That tree is in a rock. Would they have a fear of humans? Like a natural fear of just anything that moves? I guess they would, because we look like zombies. I mean, we don't shamble along, but we look like zombies. And zombies do chase animals. So I guess it's possible. Or should I say probable. I still hear zombies. That... Fat guy is fighting a bear, which that fat guy's never gonna win. That bear's gonna kick his ass. Anyways, I have other priorities to pay attention to. Anyways, what was I saying? I actually don't know what I was saying anymore. Kind of getting back on topic with where I was. As I said, I'm recording with Shadow Play. But I'm playing the game right now at 1440p. So 2060 or whatever the crap the resolution is by 1440. But the Shadow Play is going to output at 1080. It's kind of weird. I never saw a setting, and it does slightly confuse me how Shadow Play works. When I was playing with it earlier, when I did the video with Fallout 3, the Will It Run on Windows 10, I tested out to see if Fallout 3 would run, and one of the big things that I did... What do I only have? Oh, that's Iron Arrow. I don't care about Iron Arrows right now. I do care about just regular arrows. Let's use those. Anyways, what I was worried about was... recording the screen and then playing the game, which changed the resolution. But Shadow Play does a really interesting thing. No matter what I recorded or how I recorded it, it always outputted at 1080. So the entire time I was doing the video about will it run, will Fallout 3 run on Windows 10, I didn't have to stop recording at any point in time, which I thought was really cool. So I could continue playing or switch between Fallout 3 and Windows, and didn't have to stop and then resync audio and any of that BS, which I really liked. But I did notice that it always recorded at 1080, no matter what the setting was set to. So I don't know if this is going to record at 1440. Probably isn't. But I am mildly curious what Adobe Premiere is going to do with this video. Because Adobe Premiere automatically adjusts itself to the input source. So when I create a video in 720p and set it to YouTube HD, it automatically sets the output resolution to 720. But if I record at 1080, it automatically sets the output resolution to 1080, which I think is really, really neat. All right, so load faulty arrows because I don't have a lot of I don't have any experience making anything yet. So this is all very, very new. So let's see what we can do. We gotta start killing these things because... Whoa, how did I miss that? Oh, I'm used to the crossbow. The crossbow is weird. Oh, I still can't see. They need to fix that. That's one of the things they really need to fix. This is where the bow is supposed to be in your sight. Hey, look, I'm level 2. I think I drew other zombies. Undetected, but that guy is heading in this direction with a purpose. So I gotta be careful. I don't want to draw a horde. That would be bad. But I think this is a pretty good spot to chill for the night. I can see lots of things coming. I think this looks like a pretty good spot just in general. Gonna waste my arrows. Yep. Let's just let him wander on past. Oh, and he's wandering back the way he came. Interesting. Alright, so I should probably get started on my plan, which I think I need more logs for. But, yeah, I think this is going to be a really good spot to set up permanent camp. It looks really nice. We are in a desert, which I have found deserts are really, really, really good places to find, stuff lying around. Like the bird's nests. They're really easy to see in the desert. But we were also on the edge of a forest? Well, I was going to say forest biome, but fuck, I have no idea what the biome names are. How many do I have? 16. That's not a hell of a lot. This is a trick I learned in the previous incarnation of the game, of my game. Anyways, you can use, I think I need more rocks. Just got the funny feeling that I'm going to need more rocks. But you, if you climb up high enough, the zombies don't bother you. I'm probably out of rocks, and I'm going to need more rocks. No, I have one small stone. I've got to wait for these to finish. Fucking hay. Waiting for time sucks. I heard a thing. There's a zombie over there. You know, they say when humans evolved, one of the big things that they did is that they stood up so they could see over the grass. Doesn't seem to be helping much. Though, my character may just be short. I don't know. Are they costing character? Oh, I'm level 3 now because I made all of these wood frames. I'm not going to use that. That's probably just going to get destroyed because who gives a crap? What was I looking for? Oh, yes. I need to repair my axe. Anyways, so I found that if you get up high enough, zombies don't bother you because you're out of their range of sensing. So I'm going to abuse the hell out of that factor. And down the tree goes. Bloop. And basically what I'm going to do, I'm going to do what I did in the last game, where I created a hideout, basically. And it's going to take a while to build. It's going to take a lot of wood, but conveniently there is a forest right there. So when I'm ready, probably tomorrow, I will be able to... get all the wood I need to build, which is awesome. And then I'm going to build over here on the cliff face. So I primarily have one direction that I have to worry about with the zombies. And I have a few tricks to deal with them, too. Though I think the zombies might be able to climb that. But either way, I can climb down that. I don't know if I'd be able to climb back up, but I can climb down that. And that is a good escape route. So I don't think... I want to kill the pig, but I don't have a storage spot yet. But that's also a very good sign around here. In my old home... I think killing zombies draws other zombies. That's an interesting thing to worry about. But anyways... Oh, God damn it, I can't see around the damn bow! That is really... Killing zombies do draw other zombies. That is something that most definitely happens. That is something to remember. But I think that was something that happened in the previous versions. God damn it. He moved the different direction than I expected him to move. Aiming is a pain in the butt. I don't have many arrows left, do I? 15. That's enough. I have found that killing zombies with a bow is way the crap easier than dealing with them close up with, like, the stone axe or even any kind of melee weapon. I mean, a melee weapon is useful to have in emergency situations, but if you can use a bow, use a bow. Seriously. Alright. So, yeah, 1,800 hours. We still got lots of time. Pick up some more stone. Undetected, but what is that? I don't know. Not sure. What was I saying? I don't remember what the crap I was saying. Of course I don't remember what the crap I was saying. I never remember what the crap I was saying. I get distracted far too damn easily. Yeah, always use a bow to kill zombies because you don't, you just really do not want to give them the chance. There's only one type of zombie that uses projectiles, and that's the cop zombie. And they don't show up unless you're in a big city, not like that one that you can just barely see, because the draw distance is a circle instead of a square. Or is it a square? It is just a square that rotates with me. Actually, I think that's the trick. It's because the draw distance is a square, not a circle, and the square rotates with me. So I'm actually seeing further on the side because of the corner of said square. Anyways. Yeah. Cop zombies don't show up unless you're in a big city or if it's a seventh day horde, which can potentially be a problem. And that is probably where I'm going to die, primarily, is seventh day hordes. Because zombies like this, they're easy to deal with. Seventh day zombies, not so easy to deal with. Alright. Yeah, right here looks good. It also looks like a good spot to pick off stragglers once I get higher level weaponry. So, like, higher level bows or the crossbow, if I can ever find the blueprint. You know, I played the previous save game for, I don't know, a bloody week? No, longer than a week. I think a week total. Like, if you counted up all the hours actually played, I bet you it would count as a week. Before I found the crossbow blueprint. It was, like, three cities over in a freaking gas station, too. It was ridiculous. I'm like, What? Why? And then I just found it on a zombie, like 2 days later. Confused the hell out of me. I don't understand. Anyways. Alright, so what did I just make? Planks. So let's make some more wood frames. We are pushing it pretty close. I don't think I have enough wood frames yet to do what I... what's really safe to do. What else do I need? I need sticks. Lots and lots and lots of logs. Stones. So I can start cleaning this place, basically. Purging this place. Because there's a lot of zombies around here. I find the desert is actually a pretty good place to chill. To set up camp, because the desert doesn't spawn as many zombies. At least it doesn't feel like it spawns as many zombies. You can also see really, really far, like into the woods. My vision's being blocked by trees, but I can see the whole way to the fog level. All right, so 2,000 hours. Zombies start running at 2,200. What was that? Oh, that was just a stone, or pile of dirt, or whatever. Really want to kill the animals around here so I can get some decent food, but not going to do that. Don't have to yet. Don't plan to yet. Come on. He was running away from the zombie over there, I think. Not sure. Eh, it's just sticks. Was hoping that was logs. Anyways, alright, so we got 24 wood frames. That's actually one less than I was hoping for. I technically do have 2 more hours. So I could fairly easily run to the forest and make some more. You know, unless we have the whole zombie problem. They're leaving. So let's go over here. Yeah, one of the big things to know about this game is to avoid confrontation when possible. Chopping down trees is incredibly dangerous and mildly stupid. And takes more freaking ever. But unlike Minecraft, you can actually stop and then pick up where you left off as long as you don't attack something else. At least that's... no, that's... damage is consistent. Tree. Yeah, damaging blocks is a consistent thing, whereas upgrading blocks is not consistent. So, I can... what was I saying? Yeah, I can start chopping down a tree, stop, do other things, and come back to the tree and finish chopping it down where I left off. I like that. But upgrading blocks, like if you're taking these wood frames and turning them into real blocks. Whoop. Oh, can I not do this anymore? Oh, okay, I can. Yes, I'm taking an old standby from Minecraft and pillaring up. And this normally wouldn't work in 7 Days to Die because zombies will just tear down blocks. Unless you go high enough. Actually, no, I just need 6 more. Now, I'm fairly sure that 25 blocks is high enough. Because that's where I was last time. But I think the detection radius, as long as you're not carrying anything smelly, or have gas or whatever, is 30 blocks. And, of course, the other things like being smelly or carrying, yeah, being smelly in general. Woo! Come on, one more. There we go. Yeah, being smelly in general is, or will increase that significantly. Like, I think if you carry something on your belt, which is the bar at the bottom here, it will actually increase your detection radius by 30 whole meters. 30 meters! That's 30 freaking blocks, as far as I can tell, anyways. It looks like the blocks are based on meters. Just like in Minecraft. It looks right. I don't think it is right, but it looks right. I'm gonna go with it. So, as the sun sets on day one, and I hear creepy music, I am going to end the episode here because night is going to get boring for the most part. I'm going to do like I did in the previous series that I did, where I basically just cut out the video. I kept recording, but I cut it out if nothing happened. So, if nothing happens, I will end the episode here, and I will say to you guys, as always, keep playing the game, and have fun. You ever notice how the clouds are always going to the left, no matter which direction you're looking? And the moon, the parts that aren't lit up, are transparent, and they really, really should not be.